I know you're nervous, but you have to understand your role. Tonight, you will be a sacrifice, but a sacrifice for the greater good, our plan. And Davari, I assure you that that sacrifice will not go without its reward.
Muhammad, من نمیخوام برم اونجا.
Stop. با من گوش کن.
نه من نمیخوام این شب با Undertaker.
با من گوش کن.
Sacrifice for the greater good here tonight. Hassan claims that this sacrifice will have its reward. Whatever that means.
Following contest is scheduled for
one fall,
making his way to the ring from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 200 pounds.
Davari.
Well, I don't know a lot about a lot of things, but I do think Davari is going to be a sacrifice, and I do think that Davari is downright, flat out, terrified right now, and he should be.
Well, remember, 2.5 weeks from tonight, July 24th, Muhammad Hassan will meet The Undertaker at the Great American Bash. It is a number one contenders matchup. The winner will be in line for an opportunity to win the World Heavyweight Championship.
I'm telling you, Colt Davari's scared to death. I'm telling you.
And he should be.
Yeah, exactly.
And Taz, I've been talking about this all night long. The fact that all the years of covering The Undertaker, calling his matches, I've never quite seen him in the mood that he has been in toward Hassan and Davari over the past couple of weeks.
This is a perfect opportunity for The Undertaker to send a deadly message to Hassan, using Davari as the sacrificial lamb. And look at this guy, he is terrified, I'm telling you.
I mean, last week we saw The Undertaker get disqualified in that six-man elimination matchup for the SmackDown Championship because Hassan had irked him so badly earlier on in the evening. I mean, the thunderous chairs to the skull of Hassan last week.
Davari, I don't know if he's trying to work out a game plan or something. Hassan's not really telling him much. I don't know if he's trying to politic his way out of this thing or what. Uh-uh, not gonna happen. Dead man's in route. He's gonna get there, trust me.
Hassan said that Davari and this sacrifice would be rewarded.
Yeah, okay, right. I'll believe that, all right.
I mean, you cannot understand, ladies and gentlemen. Guys, maybe you can explain it, what it feels like to be on the opposite end of the ring from The Undertaker as he makes this eerie, almost chilling entrance.
It's scary as hell. Take it from someone who's experienced it, and that's me. And that's one reason why I'm sitting right here next to you, Cole, because I don't want to deal with that dude, that dead man, right there in the black hat. I tell you, it's Davari. He's trying to get out of this thing.
Hassan trying to calm Davari down. Man, there has never been anyone quite like The Undertaker in the history of sports entertainment.
Look at Davari, looks like he's seen a ghost.
I don't believe there's ever been a man that has been able to play mind games, the psychological warfare by The Undertaker. The Undertaker Show.
Remember what The Undertaker said a couple of weeks ago? Talk is cheap, but death is forever.
So The Undertaker, he's staring at his son, the man he meets at the Great American Bash. And you got that number one contenders matchup.
You got to figure that Undertaker saying that's got to be wearing on Daivari's mind right now.
As Daivari gingerly makes his way into the ring.
You might want to lose that ginger in his gingerly step, because it's going to be a nasty fight that he's in about 2 seconds.
Undertaker's opponent's Daivari, but his eyes trained on Hassan a few moments ago. And Daivari said, you know what, I don't think I'm quite up to the task here tonight. A little breather to start.
You have to. He's putting
it in the front. Okay, I said you have to. Hassan just said it's part of the plan. I can't believe he just threw his old man in there.
I can't believe this. The sacrificial lamb, as you called Daivari earlier. Pleading for The Undertaker.
Trying to talk his way out of this. He got goozled. Daivari's going to go for a big ride here.
Undertaker was staring at Hassan. This is a message to you, Muhammad Hassan, from The Undertaker.
Hassan could care less that his man just got driven damn near through the ring.
Undertaker continues to look at his opponent.
Oh, man, Cole.
Oh, my.
Tombstone.
Oh, my.
Looking right at Muhammad Hassan.
Tombstone. Pile driver.
Talk about a sacrifice.
A cover. It is over. The Undertaker impressive, but an emotionless.
Here's your winner, The Undertaker.
Why is Muhammad Hassan smiling and grinning? What's he doing?
Hell.
What the hell is this? What the hell is this?
Two guys in masks.
Wait, what the hell is going on here?
And a third guy with some sort of club.
There's a fourth guy, Cole.
And a fourth.
Oh, my God.
The club off the head of The Undertaker.
The size of these guys.
Five men in masks.
Big men. Very big men.
And Hassan is directing traffic.
Oh, my God. And beat the hell.
You too.
Oh, man.
The Undertaker being assaulted.
Oh my God!
Choke him!
I guess this is the reward.
Choke him! Get the one!
God, Cole, beat the daylights out of Undertaker.
The Undertaker being assaulted.
What the hell is that in his hand? What is that?
What is that? Oh no! Oh my God, like a steel wire.
I don't know what it is. It's some guy's choking out the Undertaker over it.
The Undertaker being brutally beaten here.
I don't know what it is.
Undertaker struggling.
Oh my God, someone's got to get help here.
Choke him.
This is, oh my God. All right, someone's got to stop this guy. He's choking him out here.
I can't.
He's turning pink.
Now Hassan.
About a coward, huh?
The Undertaker's helpless.
Oh my God.
Oh, no!
What the hell is he doing? Hassan, what is this?
Oh no. Hassan with the camel clutch.
Yeah. Oh my God. Undertaker's not even conscious, Paul. Look at his face.
Undertaker rendered helpless.
Oh my God, look at his face, Paul. I've never seen Undertaker look like this.
A beat red, his eyes rolled back in the back of his head.
I don't ever remember Undertaker. Look at these guys on their knees, these thugs or whatever the hell they are with the mask, and they're all on their knees like.
This must be what Muhammad Hassan meant earlier tonight when he said Daivari was going to be a sacrifice for a greater good, and that sacrifice would have its reward.
I think you're right, Cole. Hello, I think that's exactly what this is. But oh my God, the big picture here is
I've never seen The Undertaker left like this.
No, the condition of The Undertaker. And now they kept they those guys, they grab the Davari, and oh my, look at this, they're holding him up a bit. Like a sacrifice, like a, some kind of a, sort of, like it's a martyr or something, like, you know what I mean? Like it's a martyr.
Right.
I never seen nothing like this in the industry myself, but this is a little crazy, weird. Gotta get help out here for the Undertaker. I'm telling you, man, he's hurt.
Undertaker has no clue where he's at.
Wow. Muhammad Hussain will not take his eyes off of the Undertaker.
How about a transformation?